Hi, ho, my peeps. Well, tonight is all about the Bathtime Confessional. And I am going to use up the last of my Lush, I don't know if it's a bubble, it's not a bubble bar. I guess it's a bath bomb. And this one is gold. Blanc. Isn't that neat? I'm going to rinse out. I got to get all the glitter. Got to save all that glitter. Yeah, that's cool, huh? It looks like a little golden egg. So, I'm going to, and it's full of glitter, which I just, you know me, gotta have my bling. Right, Miss Lilybug Lane? Yeah, Lala agrees with me. Every girl needs her bling. All right, I'm gonna let that do its thing, and then I'm gonna come back.
Howdy ho, my peeps! Okay, I am Bathtime confessionaling tonight. First, let's start with my do. Got the messy bun going, and I've got this wonderful tiara. I don't know how well you can see that. Grant was cleaning up his office, and when he moved the piano, because we're getting rid of the piano, he found this weird little, very old tiara. The plastic's all breaking on it, so it looks pretty old. You can tell by the way it's constructed. So I'm just kind of digging it. I'm feeling quite queenly tonight. All right, so let's just do that sniffy sniffy. All right, here we go. Okay, here's what's left of my bath bomb. I must prepare. Oh, you know, you would think it would smell like lemon, but it doesn't. It smells like a kitchen. It smells like vanilla and a little nutmeg, maybe. No cinnamon. It smells very, very warm. It smells like one of my mother's successful baking adventures. Now, she didn't have very many. My mother was not a successful cook in many ways. She was wonderful with some things, beans and cornbread and so forth, but when it came to baking, she was a lost girl. However, she did have a few signature goodies that she would make, and one of them was, and I think I've told you guys, I'm putting this back in the water, I think I told you guys this, she would, when she was in New Orleans, one of the times she was in New Orleans, oh, I gotta lean back, my back hurts. Oh, shoot, I left the toilet lit up, sorry. God. You can dress me up, but you can't take me out. Okay, let's see if I can manage to do this with my tiara on and without showing my boobies. Okay, no, lost the tiara, but that's all right. Okay, so anyhow, on one of her trips to New Orleans, she took a cooking class at Emeril Lagasse's his restaurant there in New Orleans. And one of the things they learned to make was the bread pudding, Emeril Lagasse's bread pudding. Now, this bread pudding is, I mean, it puts all other bread puddings to shame. I mean, you start with a regular bread pudding with or without the raisins. You know, you put that together how you always would. But he uses, I believe, three different types of cream that goes on it. There's like a creamy whiskey sauce that you pour on it first. And then there's a thicker, like a spiced cream sauce that you pour on top of that. And I believe the last thing you did was you dolloped a bunch of this spiced whipped cream on the top. So this stuff was heavenly good. And she, you know, she made it right down to the letter. I'm sure she did. Because if she had screwed up, you would have been able to tell. Poor woman couldn't bake. Anyhow, it was so wonderful. And that's what this this bath bomb reminds me of. It kind of smells like that, her kitchen on a day that she had decided to make this bread pudding. And she would only make it for special occasions. Like, she would make it sometimes for Thanksgiving or Christmas or maybe somebody's birthday. So, yeah. So that's kind of a nice memory. All right. So you want to play with the angel? I think we need to play with, not angel, our moon fairy. Let's go get the moon fairy.
Okay, here we go. I'm so excited. I guess we should probably just let her take a header into the water. Ah, moon fairy! Where'd she go? Where'd her go? Oh, moon fairy! Come back! Oh my gosh! Oh, she's down there somewhere. Okay, well, she's down there somewhere. And, I don't know what she's doing. I'm not sure I trust that moon fairy now. Wait, is that her? Oh no, that's the bath bomb. Well, we're going to let her, puff up to whatever side she's going to puff up to while we get to the bottom of this Bathtime Confessional.
Alrighty, so a little life update. My depression has remained at bay. Look at my dirty clothes on the floor. God, I'm such a slob. It has remained at bay ever since it went away on Monday. It's Friday today. And I have been busy. I have been productive. I've had fun. I went to the movies with Gracie. We saw Snatch. It was hilarious, although I can't stand Amy Schumer. You know that Amy Schumer, she's funny and all that, but she reminds me of all the mean girls in high school. They were all a little chunky, and they all had that little ferrety face and that thin blonde hair, and they had these mean attitudes, and they would say snide things under their breath at you just to get a reaction. Yeah, that's who she reminds me of, so I don't like her at all. But she was great with Goldie Hawn in that movie. Goldie Hawn was wonderful in the movie. I just loved it. In fact, you know, it's funny. I think I like Goldie Hawn and her acting better now than when she was younger. She's really come into her own. So anyhow, I did that. Today, I finally cleaned the living room. And let me tell you, it required moving all the furniture away from the wall. I had to use a broom first to get up the dog hair. And then I had to use a vacuum, which I changed probably. I dumped it probably 6 times. Everything had to be dusted, you know, vacuumed, blah, blah, blah. There was a ton, and I mean a ton, of Grant's crap all over the living room. Now, my crap's all over the dining area. His crap was all over the living room. So, I just boxed it up, put it in the office, and he can deal with it from there. So, anyhow, I'm feeling pretty good. I mean, I can sit on my couch. I've got chairs that don't have anything on them. I can sit on those. It feels really wonderful. So, I did that, and oh, my back itches. Let's see here. Going to scratch my back. Owie. Okay, that's gone. Whatever it was. I hope it wasn't a bug. All right, so I have been making a list of videos that I want to do. I keep looking here instead of there. Okay, I've been making a list of videos that I want to do, and let me consult the Oracle, which is the back of an envelope. All right, so I'm going to just read to you some of the things that are coming up. I'm going to be doing a DIY for a kind of a glittery galaxy bead that you can make out of nail polish and a flat glass stone. I'm going to do the story of my Facebook page. Now, I just started a new Facebook page for Cheryl Coyote. So if you want to go like me on Facebook, I'm Cheryl Coyote on Facebook. It's a brand new page. And I have a kind of an interesting profile pic, which I should have brought a copy of. Maybe I'll insert one here. Okay, so that's my profile pic. Anyhow, I'm going to tell you how that came about. And I think I'm going to do that tonight. I think that's going to be tonight's confessional. So, in addition to that, I've got I've got a review on some wireless outdoor lights that are solar-powered and motion sensor. So that's going to be upcoming. I'm going to do a DIY on making ball cap magnets, like the magnets that I gave to 49L Davis. I want to try doing an aloe hair pack with the aloe that's growing outside in my yard. Supposed to, you know, make your hair all wonderful. So we'll see what happens. Oh, another thing I want to show you. A while back, I ordered... Oh, my arm's falling asleep. I got to do this side. Okay, so a while back, I ordered some contact lenses that are... I got to shake my hand. That are... Well, I guess unicorn is what you would call them. They're sort of blue and purple and pink. They're really cool. I don't know why I ordered them. They were $1. I thought they looked like fun. So I'm going to put those in and show you that on video one of these days. Also, I've got more $3 dinners. I said I was going to do them this week, but I just have not had time. I'm going to do an update to my plastic bottle beads video showing how to do the beads with a heat gun instead of a candle. So that's going to be interesting. I have a DIY eyeshadow, like a tutorial coming up. And that's all I've got coming up. So let's talk about the profile pic. Let me get back into my comfy position. Let's see. First, let's see. Where's the dang moon fairy? Is it down there somewhere? Well, where is it? She's not there. Something very bad has happened to the moon fairy. All right. She didn't... Maybe they told it backwards. Maybe she was supposed to get 600 times smaller. I don't know. But she's not down there. I don't know what happened to her. But we'll find out. We'll get to the bottom of it. Anyhow, so my profile pic... Gosh, I should have used a tripod. I'm sorry. Anyhow, my profile pic is supposed to depict... two angel wings linked together to look like the chi, or what people also call the yin yang symbol. Okay, for those of you who have been with me since the Alexis Wiseman days, you know that my channel used to be called Alexis Wiseman, and that Alexis Wiseman was... Well, she still is, I guess, a character that I had written a story about. And Alexis has a long backstory, but Alexis was a minor character in a larger story that I had written about two angels, for lack of a better word, that live on the earth and they harvest souls. The dark angel harvests souls for what we think of as hell or the devil. But if in the story, hell and the devil are not like, they're not, they equal antimatter, essentially, is what hell and the devil is. It equals antimatter. And then there are angels that harvest souls for the light. These two angels are named Nox. That's the male angel. Nox means dark, or darkness. And so he harvests antimatter in the world. The other angel's name, she's a female. Her name is Lucy, which means light. And she harvests souls as matter, actual matter. So in order to keep the universe, you know, not imploding on itself, these two angels, along with others that are in the world, we never meet the others, but there are others there as well doing this, they are harvesting matter and antimatter all the time in order to keep the balance of, you know, of substance, of being. So these two are never supposed to meet one another. In fact, none of the angels are supposed to meet one another. But through a series of circumstances, these two do meet one another. And they understand they're on two different teams of the same side, almost. It's like they know that they're doing oppositional behavior, but somehow they understand that both of their behaviors are important to reality, to substance, to being. So they kind of team up and they start doing their harvesting sort of together. So They go through this series of episodes where they're meeting these different people, and you don't know which side the person is going to go on to until the end of that part of the story. Whether they go to the light or the dark, you don't know. There's always a choice that that the human has to make, whether they're going to go to the light or to the dark. So as the story progresses, these two angels begin to feel an attraction for one another, but not like we understand as sexual attraction. It's more of a magnetic attraction. They are most comfortable when they're in close proximity to one another. They're able to express themselves to one another or in a way that they can't to any other beings that they know of. And so they find themselves being more closely drawn together. Well, at one point, they actually meld their spirits, for lack of a better word, meld, and they take on part of the substance of the other. And when this happens, this symbol appears on both of their bodies, right over where their heart would be. They don't have hearts, but they just look human. They're not actually human. So this symbol shows up over where their heart would be, on both of their bodies. And the symbol, obviously, is the melding or the perfect balance of these two entities. That's where that symbol came from. And a friend of mine, I had designed a symbol that was more realistic looking. And then a friend of mine who is an illustrator, I asked him if he would come up with a symbol, you know, that looked like this angel wing thing. And that's what he came up with, the symbol that you're looking at on my Facebook profile. So that's the story. The story never really had an end. I stopped it at a certain point, and it never continued. So I don't know what happened to these, you know, these two angels. But the way Alexis Wiseman works into the whole deal is she ended up working for Lucy. Lucy had her cover was that she was like a commentator for E! Or one of those news magazine things. And so she hired Alexis as sort of a personal secretary. And so Alexis, who has her whole own backstory, was like a tangential secondary character in this story. Well, when I stopped writing the story, the main story, I was still kind of taken with Alexis, so I continued to write her story, and I wrote it in blog form. So there's a blog out there somewhere that might even be purged by now, that talks about Alexis's life and what she's going through at the time and blah, 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 blah. So Alexis doesn't really have anything to do with this symbol, only in that she was working with Lucy, who had the symbol on her chest right above where her heart would be. So that's the story. I love that story. I would like to go back and write some more of that. So anyhow, what's coming up? Well, there is a good possibility that Leanne and Joel may come and see me on Sunday. I'm so hoping they do. We're not quite sure if our schedules are all going to match up. So it's going to be a real kind of a spur of the moment thing. And if they do come see me, there will be much video and hilarity to share with you. And I'm really looking forward to that. So hopefully I'll have that little day to hang out with them. And then Monday and Tuesday I'll be home. I'll be cleaning like I'm doing now. I'll probably work more outside though. And then Wednesday I get in my car, I drive to Abigail's, and we head to the Pacific Northwest. So we're going to drive north for 5 or 6 days, something like that. And then we're going to turn around and drive home for 5 or 6 days. So that is going to be a very fun girls' road trip. And we're not planning it. We didn't get reservations anywhere. We're just, you know, just hopping in the car, and we're just going to point ourselves north. So that is going to be an interesting adventure. The last time we did this, we also didn't do reservations, but we were hauling a trailer, you know, so we were like a two-headed turtle. We had our home on our back, right? As soon as we saw a Walmart parking lot, well, we were home. It was time to pull over and get something out of the refrigerator and fluff the blankets and, you know, settle in for the night. So we're not going to be doing that on this trip. This trip, we're going to have to find lodging. So that is going to be very interesting. But, you know, thank God for cell phones and the internet. We can call ahead, blah, blah, blah. So it'll be fine. It'll all work out. So when I come back from that trip, I am going to continue on doing the trust administration that I've been trying to mop up for my parents' estate. There's not a whole lot in their estate anymore. I mean, when they put this all of this together, they had more assets. But you know, as Mama aged and she used up a lot of her assets, there's just not that much left, and that's no big deal. I mean, my brother and sister and I always wanted our mother. Well, both our parents, but after my dad died, we wanted our mother just to have fun. You know, just take her money and have fun with it. So, although she wasn't feeling like having much fun, we did manage to get her to go on a couple trips and, you know, buy some stuff. And she, you know, she had as much fun as she possibly could while being a, you know, cancer patient. So, that's about all the yapping I feel like doing tonight. My hand has fallen asleep. I hope I don't drop the phone. Oh, wait. We have to see what happened to the moon.
Well, hell, look at her. She looks sad. Poor little thing. I'm going to plop her back in the water. I should have read my instructions. I mean, the way it says on the front, it's like, grows to 600%, just put it in water. So it makes you feel like, oh, you know, she's going to grow immediately. Well, no. I mean, it says here that it can take up to, where is it? It can take up to 72 hours for her to grow. Dang. In 72 hours, she is supposed to be, you know, 600% bigger. Dang it. This is not a food product. Do not swallow. Okay, I won't swallow. I'll spit and sid. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye!